Hi, my name is Salita Adams. I'm an assistant professor of English at Bossier Parish Community College. Today I want to introduce to you the argumentation essay, which is what I teach for English 101, freshman composition. And as you can see on the board, your primary goal for an argumentation essay is to have your audience believe as you do. Make your audience adopt your belief. If that doesn't happen, then your goal becomes to at least get your audience to see and understand your point of view, even though they don't necessarily agree with all what you're telling them to believe. So to do that, to develop a strong argumentation essay, there are three steps of an argument frame that you can do to have a good, strong, well-developed argumentation essay. These three steps of an argumentation essay serves as one pre-writing technique. Step number one is ask a yes or no question. Make sure you ask a yes or no question, because whatever you believe for that particular topic, you either have to be all the way yes or all the way against it. So for example, I have an example question on the board for you to look at today, and it is based on a controversial topic, so keep that in the back of your mind. So our example is, should abortion be a woman's choice? Obviously, it's in the headlines today, it's controversial, so it makes people think automatically. So once I get my step number one, my question, already down on my piece of paper, I go to step number two, state a claim. So in layman's terms, I am telling what my answer is for step number one's question. Example, since my question was, should abortion be a woman's choice? I'm going to say, yes, abortion should be a woman's choice. Now I know this is not the most popular point of view to take about this particular subject, but I want to play devil's advocate with you for just a little bit. And if you notice, this claim that I'm stating, it should be one complete sentence that states your point of view about your topic. Don't have more than one sentence. And as you can see, I did put the word yes in front of my sentence, okay? And when you actually begin to start writing and developing your argumentation essay, your claim for step number two, which is your answer to the question, can be developed into a thesis statement. And remember, keep in mind that without a thesis statement, you have no paper. So it's imperative for you to have a strong, forceful, confident yes or no thesis statement, not both. Okay? However, whenever you develop your thesis statement based on this claim for step number two, you are not going to include the word yes or no. Okay? Now moving on to step number three of the three steps of an argument frame. You have your question, step number one. You have your answer to your question in step number two. Now you have to give your reasons for actually choosing whatever your position was in step number two. You have to articulate your reasons as because statements. If you notice, I have about three examples here. Again, our question was, should abortion be a woman's choice? Every single one of your examples must begin with the word because. And because every one of your statements begins with the word because, it is not going to be a complete sentence. In this particular step, you're actually brainstorming. This is where you're generating ideas to support your thesis statement will come into play for whenever you start writing your argumentation essay. So for example, should abortion be a woman's choice? We already said yes, it should be. Now let's list, brainstorming, our actual reasons for saying yes, it should be. Number one is because the woman might be mentally unstable. Number two, because the woman may be financially unstable. And number three, because the woman's life may be put in jeopardy if she carries to term. I do suggest that you come up with at least 5 to 7 of these because statements, these reasons for whatever your claim is in step number two, because then you get to pick and choose. And again, you have to narrow down your topic as specific as possible to have a good, concrete, strong argumentation essay. So as you can see, with these three that I've put on the board here, my reasons for stating my claim in step number two, you can, once you begin to write and draft your argumentation essay, your reasons will become body paragraphs. This is where your support for whatever you claim in step number two will take place. And as you can see, these three steps serve as one pre-writing technique to well develop a good, strong argumentation essay.